and we can only hope that this will happen so their proposals aren't school funding. I also appreciate that the issue actually of a levy and its impact on schools is in fact the smallest part of the school funding issues that schools are facing, but I would say that it is the funding aspect over which we as a council can have some direct control. It's also incredibly unfair, particularly to maintain schools who are counted within the council's employment budgets against voluntary aided and academies who will for the most part be unaffected by the levy. The apprentice levy is an idea that deserves an opportunity to succeed, but it needs to be seen as fair and equitable, I think, from the start. It's a payroll levy. It should be managed and paid corporately, and we have the option not to recharge it to the council's cost centres, and we should take that option. So where the government's consultation on the number of apprentices a public body should be employing has ended, and a rate of 2.3% has been agreed. That 2.3% will also include maintained schools within its council. As with the apprentice levy, government is suggesting it will bring forward proposals later to enable schools to access the levy and to play a part in meeting its apprentice targets. The suggestion of a graduate entry teacher apprenticeship has been floated, but we await reaction and detail behind this. But as it stands for the coming year, there are very limited opportunities for schools to draw down any credits. So, Mayor, I don't want to repeat the remarks I made earlier in the month when I spoke on this at the Budget Council, but I would refer members to the impact, particularly within the primary and special sectors, that I've laid out in the amendments. The motion tells us that the government cuts are going to be damaging, and I agree with this. It also tells us that the national cuts will impact maintained and academy schools alike. So where the apprentice levy only impacts maintained schools. I had hoped the Leader would have taken action on this before the beginning of the new financial year. I still hope he will take action, preferably by accepting the amendments and the procedure that I have laid down in the amendments and instruct officers to manage the levy centrally without recharging to schools. Because, Mr. Chair, it's all well and good constantly passing motions asking to lobby government for more money and for more action, and we'll support that. But in this case, we have the local ability to help the schools out on this one, and Mr. Mayor, I think we should take it.
Thank you, Councillor Kelly. Councillor Bill Tumquist.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I chose to concentrate on different aspects. The National Audit Office produced 40-odd page report in December about pressures on school budgets. This isn't something that Councillor Tony Smith invented. The report exists, and it gives examples of what head teachers are having to do. Dealing with what the summary says, head teachers are increasing teachers' contact time, class sizes, and the amount of teaching undertaken by senior staff. They're reducing supply teacher costs, the size of leadership teams. Reducing the number of teaching assistants was less common. They're replacing more experienced, higher-paid teachers with younger, less expensive recruits. They're recruiting staff on temporary contracts and encouraging teachers to teach outside their specialism and relying more on unqualified. ensure our economy is competitive in the strange world that we're now entering with Brexit. But we constantly say, well, we've got all these opportunities, we're going to work for them and try and achieve them. But we can't do that with a school and untrained workforce. We can't do that unless enough money is put in for training and education in the future. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Any speakers from the floor? Councillor Green.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Can I say, first of all, it is notoriously difficult to set up a national formula, and I, in the past, have voted against national formula and also written to ministers to that effect. However, I think the issue we have at the moment is that there is, the point has been made about the unfairness of so many different local funding formula and the postcode lottery that implies. And I think we should just remember, and this is on information that was provided to us by the council itself, that if implemented, 75% of rural primary schools would receive increased funding. And the facts also remain that currently, since 2010, school funding is at its highest level of more than 40 billion and will rise, as people numbers do, over the next 2 years to 42 billion. So increased funding is being put in place and a formula being set. Although, as I understand, that is still open for some consultation and some discussion, is going to try and even out some of the more egregious local impacts. So I'm afraid, given the way this particular notice of motion has been written, we won't be supporting it today. The other issue, which is very much a shame, is the amendment put forward by Stuart Kelly is a really good point, and it's one of those things that the unintended consequences of policy making, I think. And so, notwithstanding our view around the, because this just says that Labour parties, there's always the government's error, as long as they don't get a fall apart. Type resolution. I can certainly commit that we would support anything that the council does in terms of writing to ministers and explaining that this is an unintended consequence. It is clearly unfair and something should be done to ameliorate it. So, more than happy to support that, but in terms of the amendment itself, it just adds to the Labour Party saying it was the awful unintegrated Labour in power, which they're likely to be for the next 40 years for a particular.
Councillor Banks, have you all
Mr. Mayor, so many councillors say I wasn't going to speak on this issue tonight, but I was inflamed by some of the early comments made by Lib Dems and the notice of motion that's been moved by Councillor Kelly. We can't forget, and people should never ever forget, we are in a position where austerity becomes fashionable. It was a combination of Conservatives and Liberal Democrats for five long, hard years. Austerity become a way of life. They created it, and now they're trying to backtrack and say it doesn't exist. They, as a government, started this, and we were told vaguely at one time, education in schools would be exempt. Oh, this will be exempt. National insurance won't go up. But we know they can change their mind and go on. But austerity has become a way of life, almost a passion. And you created that evolution of austerity. We don't really want any lessons about that. However, the notice of motion. The first port of call seems to be for Councillor Kelly's apprentice levy, which is wrong, seems to be the council. Now, just remind people, the council have been cut, its final fine savings of 45 million this year alone. So, we say to government, we must protest, oh, but we'll pay the bill for you. Don't think that's really a good position for this council to be from. But there is a pot of money. There's a pot of money in education that's going to ideologically driven policies, such as the creation of grammar schools. But we're okay, we've got grammar schools, we've got family schools, we're not part of it. And free schools, which have been omitted. mitigated failure over a number of years. So there's 220 million, I believe. Surely that is the first port of call for anybody to remedy an unfair formula. We don't have the money ourselves, and to simply say we will give that money up. And I do need to remind people about the Lib Dems' role in creating the atmosphere of austerity, cut after cut. It was fashionable to cut local authority, and it would appear now that Councillor Kelly is telling the government, cut us some more, and we'll pay the bill for you. I think that's incorrect.
Can I ask members who hang around the back to sit down, please? I mean, crunch away ourselves. I did say that at the start of the new school year. People have to hang around the back. It gives a bad impression to the public, especially the front of people that the public are with.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'll copy myself from the first words of Councillor Harris. I wasn't going to go and speak, but the diatribe came out of the night to respond. This government was a busted flush when the coalition took over, and the busted flush now, we see that by the election results that are taking place all over the country, spread over by elections and local councils. Losing seats left, right and centre, but even losing seats at the top. That really gets me. I mean, we have four more seats than anybody else. But I must remind Council Powers, as much as he went on, about the fair time of the cuts and the cuts and the cuts. I didn't interrupt you. Yeah. Going on about the cuts and the cuts and the cuts, but the Liberal Democrats in Parliament, the Prime brought in the benefits for the children. The pupil premium was brought in by the Liberal Democrats specifically to improve those children that needed the assistance to gain better education. They were the poor, the disabled children.